The Scrum Guide, the definitive guide to Scrum, the rules of the game. Huge thank you to the gentlemen, the co-creators of Scrum, that put this together, Ken Schwaber and Jeff Sutherland. And you can see I've included a link. This is under the creativecommons.org license. You can get the actual PDF from the link on the left-hand side of the screen. I've taught Scrum to my students, but some of them struggle with Scrum. So I have put this in this format to help them digest the content a little bit better. Ken Schwaber and Jeff Sutherland worked on Scrum until 1995 when they co-presented Scrum at the Uppsala conference in 1995. This presentation essentially documented the learning that Ken and Jeff had gained over the previous few years and made public the first formal definition of Scrum. The history of Scrum is described elsewhere. To honor the first places where it was tried and refined, we recognize Individual Inc., Newspage, Fidelity Investments, and IDX, now GE Medical. The Scrum Guide documents Scrum has developed, evolved, and sustained for 20 plus years by Jeff Sutherland and Ken Schwaber. Other sources provide you with patterns, processes, and insights that complement the Scrum framework. These may increase productivity, value, creativity, and satisfaction with the results. Purpose of the Scrum Guide. Scrum is a framework for developing, delivering, and sustaining complex products. This guide contains the definition of Scrum. This definition consists of Scrum's roles, events, artifacts, and the rules that bind them together. Ken Schwaber and Jeff Sutherland developed Scrum. The Scrum Guide is written and provided by them. Together, they stand behind the Scrum Guide. Definition of Scrum. A framework within which people can address complex adaptive problems while productively and creatively delivering products of the highest possible value. Scrum is simple to understand, lightweight, and watch this, difficult to master. Contrary to what people think, Scrum is not easy to master. It's simple, but it's hard to master. It requires discipline. Definition of Scrum. Scrum is a process framework that has been used to manage work on complex products since the early 1990s. Scrum is not a process technique or definitive method. Rather, it is a framework within which you can employ various processes and techniques. Scrum makes clear the relative efficacy of your product management and work techniques so that you can continuously improve the product, the team, and the working environment. The Scrum framework consists of Scrum teams and the associated roles, events, artifacts, and rules. Each component within the framework serves a specific purpose and is essential to Scrum's success and usage. The rules of Scrum bind together the roles, events, and artifacts, governing the relationships and interaction between them. The rules of Scrum are described throughout the body of this document. Specific tactics for using the Scrum framework vary and are described elsewhere. Uses of Scrum. Scrum was initially developed for managing and developing products. Starting in the early 1990s, Scrum has been used extensively worldwide to develop products and enhancements, research and identify viable markets, technologies, and product capabilities, release products and enhancements as frequently as many times a day, develop and sustain cloud, online, secure, on-demand, and other operational environments for product use, and sustain and renew products. Uses of Scrum. Scrum has been used to develop software, hardware, embed software, networks of interacting function, autonomous vehicles, schools, government, marketing, managing, the operation of organizations, and almost everything we use in our daily lives as individuals and societies, as technology, market, and environmental complexities and their interactions have rapidly increased, Scrum's utility in dealing with complexities proven daily. Scrum proved especially effective in iterative and incremental knowledge transfer. Scrum is now widely used for products, services, and the management of the parent organization. The essence of Scrum is a small team of people. The individual team is highly flexible and adaptive. These strengths continue operating in single, several, many, and networks of teams that develop, release, operate, and sustain the work and work products of thousands of people. They collaborate and interpolate through sophisticated development architectures and target release environments. When the words develop and development are used in the Scrum Guide, they refer to complex work such as those types identified above. Scrum theory. Scrum is founded on empirical process control theory, or empiricism. Empiricism asserts that knowledge comes from experience and making decisions based on what is known. Scrum employs an iterative, incremental approach to optimize predictability and control risk. Three pillars uphold every implementation of empirical process control: transparency, inspection, and adaptation. Let's talk about transparency. Significant aspects of the process must be visible to those responsible for the outcome. Transparency requires those aspects be defined by a common standard, so observers share a common understanding of what is being seen. For example, a common language referring to the process must be shared by all participants, and those performing the work and those inspecting the resulting increment must share a common definition of done. Inspection. Scrum users must frequently inspect Scrum artifacts and progress towards a sprint goal to detect undesirable variances. The inspection should not be so frequent that inspection gets in the way of the work. Inspections are most beneficial when diligently performed by skilled inspectors at the work point. At the point of work. And that concludes our first look at this documentation.